purpose or your central claim or your over the course of the passage type of questions. Okay, so this comes under the first bracket. Second, we have your evidence-based question. Turn to the other page, please. What does it say? You have the second question and the third question, which are actually interconnected, right? The narrator implies that Catherine, and then you have multiple choice questions, and then you have the third question, which says which choice provides the best evidence for the answer to the previous question. So it is interconnected, right? So that is your evidence-based question. Next, we move on to an interesting question, which I really like, which is your contextual question, wherein you will have to look at vocabulary as your answer. Okay, this is your contextual question. Here, what you need to remember is context is king. Now, if I ask you, what is the meaning of adage, adage or adage? What is the meaning of adage or adage? Who said that? Okay. Now, what is the meaning of condescending? Okay, you know the meaning? Okay, keep. You know the meaning. Okay, tell me. No, tell me, that's okay. What is the meaning?
Descending from some place?
No, no. Descending was somewhat similar. Okay, now if I use it in a context, if I say, the superior spoke to the schoolboy or to the office boy in a very condescending note.
Serious.
Tone, sorry, condescending tone. What does it mean? Yes, to put someone down, right? So you got the meaning now? Okay, so when you put the word in a particular context is when you get the meaning. So that is your contextual type of question, okay? Next, we move on to your and but to type of question. Here, there will be two sentences divided by these words, okay? Wherein sentence one could be divided by that word. What you need to do is both the sentences have to be correct. Even if one is correct and the other is wrong, then that is not my answer. Okay, now what am I saying, like you should get the answer? There is one element that is very important in SAT reading comprehension that is called word matching. Okay, now what is word matching? For example, I have in the option choice which says, there is a gulf between the friends. Okay, and when I go back to the passage, I see there are serious differences in the relationship. Now, which is my word matching? Gulf and differences. Now, this is how you need to find your answer. Alright? You word match your answer, find your answer choices. This is how you do your reading comprehension. So, this is like your a holy book. Okay? You can't go against it or you can't deviate from this convention. Okay? SAT is almost like math. Follow conventions and you will get your answer. It's not rocket science, or it is not English per se. It is all about following conventions. Anyone can do. Okay? Alright? Next. I think that is it. So these are the different types of questions that will come. So let's try solving some of them. I think due to paucity of time, I don't think I can take too long. Neither are you. Okay, anyway. So, the main purpose of the first paragraph. So, remember one thing, primary purpose, central claim answers are always, or almost always, at least 99.9%, you will find the answers in the first few lines of the first paragraph and the last few lines of the last paragraph. Okay? This is your location of that particular answer. Now, what do I do after I locate? I do word match. Okay? This is how your reading comprehension for your main purpose works. Now we're talking about the first paragraph, right? So what do we look at over here? We just constrict ourselves to this particular paragraph and we see if we find the answers in the first few lines of this paragraph. Okay? Now, Do we have a distant relationship between Mr. and Mrs. Allen? Do I see discord? Do I see disenchantment? Do I see words like these?
No.
I don't. Right? So I don't go for that answer. It just says that he repaired directly to the card room. That means he just went to the card room. It's like he went to the male's room and she went to the female's room. That's it. There's no discord over there. Now, show how claustrophobic and crowded the ballroom is. Now, what is the primary purpose of this thing? The primary purpose is something that starts off a sequence. Now, what started off the sequence? Them coming late. Right? And the answer, option choice C, that is, describe the main character's belated arrival at the ball. Where is belated word matching?
Till late.
Till late. And is it in the first few lines?
Yes.
Yes, it is. Okay? This is not always true. Please don't be like, oh, first few lines. This is the primary purpose is nothing but your summary of a particular passage. For example, if I'm talking about global warming and its impact, what would be the summary? Global warming and its impact. Okay, so anecdotes such as my childhood experience when I was in Bangalore, when it was much cooler than what it is right now, those small incidents in a paragraph will never be your summary type of answer. Okay, those are overarching answers will always be your main purpose answers. Okay, next. I'll just give you the technique for the evidence-based question. Here, you will have to first, look at the second question. That is the question previous to that. Prior to that. What is it talking about? Catherine. So I need to underline that. Okay, I'm talking about Catherine, so I need to stick to the brief. Next, I move on to the next question, which says these are the lines. So I have to go back to the passage, look at these lines. My answer will always be in these lines. And then what should I do? What did I tell you? Which is your holy book?
Word matching.
Word matching. Do your word matching and find your answer. Okay, now let's see what is the answer here. Did not have an enjoyable time, correct. Where did I find my answer? In option C, that is 17 to 23. Can you read it, please? Your name.
Deep.
Deep, please read it.
Catherine began to feel something of disappointment. She was tired of being continually pressed against by people. The generosity of whose faces possessed nothing to impress, with all of whom she was so fully unacquainted that she could not relieve that irksomeness of imprisonment by the exchange of a syllable with any of her fellow captives.
So do we see the word of irksomeness, of imprisonment, captives, disappointment? What is it? Word match? Well, did not have an enjoyable time. That's all. Okay? Next. Contextual question. Now, in line 12, ingenuity mostly means. Let's go to line 12. And by a continued exertion of strength and ingenuity, in which context is ingenuity being used? Very good. Dexterity is the correct answer. Now, in which context is ingenuity being used? What are they doing? What are they trying to do? They're pushing and pulling, they're moving through a crowd. Okay, so what strength are we talking about over there when you're moving through a crowd? We're talking about physical strength. Do you really need to be inventive to move through a crowd?
No.
Do you really have to be intellectual?
No.
Even a baby can move through a crowd, right? Do you need to have brilliance?
No.
You don't need to have brilliance. So the only thing that matches with strength, that is my physical strength, was dexterity, which deals with your fingers, right? How dexterous you are, ambidextrous, have you heard of that?
Yes.
You can work with two hands, right? Both the left and the right, okay? Alright, so with this we are concluding our SAT session. I hand over the piece to Mr. Shaw.